بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. سيجمنت نمبر 2، والعبادة كما عرفها. We are reading from the book فقه العبادات by الشيخ محمد بن صالح العثيمين رحمة الله عليه. And this is segment number 2. والعبادة كما عرفها شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله هي اسم جامع لما يحبه الله ويرضاه من الأقوال والأعمال الباطنة والظاهرة. عبادة has been defined by شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية may Allah send mercy in his soul is a comprehensive term which includes everything loved by Allah and pleased to Allah, saying action inward or outward. وحتى يتحقق هذا المعنى فلا بد للإنسان أن يعبد الله على الوجه الذي شرعه الله وبالكيفية التي ارتضاها سبحانه في خضوع وانقياد، ولا تكون العبادة بما يخترع الناس من أهواء وظنون. To fulfill this purpose of عبادة, so human beings have to worship Allah, but it has to be according the way how Allah legislates and according the means that pleasing to Allah سبحانه وتعالى in total submission to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. عبادة could not be according what people invent according their desires and what they want. ومرجع ذلك كله أن يستقر في النفس الشعور بمعنى العبودية لله وحده. The whole thing is about establishing in yourself total submission to Almighty Allah alone. وأن يتوجه العبد إلى الله بكل حركة في النفس والجوارح بل وكل حركة في الحياة، والتجرد إليه من كل معنى يخالف العبودية لله. It has been intended behind purpose of عبادة that a person in every second, in every breath, in every action, in every movement in his life to be according Allah and for Allah, and to be free from anything that is differ from the obedience of Allah and Allah alone. ومفهوم العبادة يبدو شاملا لكل مجالات الحياة، والواجب على العبد ألا ينفك عن طاعة خالقه فيما يصدر من سلوك في جميع أوقات حياته. وقد أمر سبحانه وتعالى نبيه محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم بعبادته في كل وقت أمرا مطلقا، قال تعالى واعبد ربك حتى يأتيك اليقين. The definition of عبادة: it covers every inch of the life. It is obligation upon the slave servant of Allah. Never be a moment without obedience to his creator in his action, in his time, in wherever he is in his life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had commanded his prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to worship him, to obey him at all time, at all action. He stated in Surah Al-Hijr verse number 99, and worship Allah until death come to you or until this approach you. وقد اتخذ الإسلام عبادات وشعائر تميزه، حدد لها أوقاتها ومقاديرها وكيفيتها، وفرض على الإنسان أداءها متى تحققت الشروط بحيث لا يستطيع الإنسان تركها وتأخيرها متى وجبت عليه. An Islam made limits for the ibadah and the symbols of Islam, which is to define what's Islam. There is times, there is numbers, there is places, everything been obligated upon the human being whenever he have the means and the conditions, which means that a person is not free to neglect it or to delay it whenever Allah makes the time for it. وهي التطبيق العملي لما اعتقده في نفسه من توحيده سبحانه وتعالى، ويتمثل أركان الإسلام العملية وقواعده الأساسية. And this is the implementation of the aqidah in yourself to single Allah with all obedience and all worship, which comes resemble in the pillars of al-Islam and the principles of al-Islam, the fundamentals of al-Islam. والقيام بشعائر الإسلام من صلاة وصيام وزكاة وحج لا بد وأن يتم وفق ما شرع الله من منهج التكليف افعل ولا تفعل. وقد أوضح الحق سبحانه هذا المنهج في كتابه العزيز، قال تعالى: ونزلنا عليك الكتاب تبيانا لكل شيء وهدى ورحمة وبشرى للمسلمين. To establish and maintain Islam regardless if it's Salah or fasting or obligatory charity or Hajj, it have to be according to the Sharia of Allah that do or don't. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this is clear in his book, and he stated in the Quran in Surah An-Nahl verse number 89: وَأَنْزَلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ تِبْيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً وَبُشْرَى لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Indeed we reveal the book to you Muhammad, or we descended the book in you Muhammad to be clarification for everything and guidance and mercy and glad tidings for the Muslims. And Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-An'am verse number 38: مَا فَرَّطْنَا فِي الْكِتَابِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ ثُمَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يُحْشَرُونَ. We didn't neglect anything in the book, and after this they will be resurrected to the Lord. وكلف نبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم ببيان آيات التنزيل وما فيها من أحكام، قال تعالى: وأنزلنا إليك الذكر لتبين للناس ما نزل إليهم ولعلهم يتفكرون. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala obligated his prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to explain the verses that been revealed to him and to explain the rules and the obligations, as he stated in Surah An-Nahl verse number 44: Indeed we had revealed the zikr, the reminder, to you O Muhammad, to explain to mankind what been revealed to them from the Lord, that they may reflect. وبعد هذا البيان يعبد الناس ربهم على بصيرة، وتنقطع حجة من عظم غير الله أو عبد الله بغير ما أمر فأحاط عبادته بالبدع والضلالات. After the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم received the book and he explained it to the people with guidance and knowledge, there is no excuse to those who honor other than Allah or worship other than Allah or worshiping Allah with different rules and regulations that he didn't legislate, similar to those people who go in misguidance and innovation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated in his book: رسلا مبشرين ومنذرين لئلا يكون للناس على الله حجة بعد الرسل وكان الله عزيزا حكيما. سورة النساء verse 165: messengers carrying the glad tidings and warning, so the people have no excuse before Allah after sending the messenger, and Allah is Almighty wise. وإذا كان المسلم بحاجة إلى طعام وشراب ليقيم صلبه ويقوي بدنه فهو بحاجة إلى ما يغذي روحه من التعرف على العقيدة الصحيحة وأسرار العبادات بما في ذلك أوقاتها ومقاديرها وكفياتها، ومؤيدة بالدليل الصحيح من الكتاب والسنة، فيروي ظمأه ويطمئن قلبه وتستقيم نفسه بأداء العبادة على وجهها المشروع. If a Muslim in a need for food and drink, so he strengthens his body, so he is in need for food and nourishment for his soul by knowing his aqidah, the proper belief and the secret behind the ibadah and worshiping Allah, by performing it in the right time and the way that Allah had designated, and to be supported with the evidence from the book of Allah and the authentic sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this way he will strengthen his soul and his life will be straight by performing the ibadah. We continue inshallah in another segment. Thank you for being here. جزاكم الله خيرا. Maybe we can take one moment. إن رسالة الله ماضية لأنها إرث العلماء وحظ المؤمنين إلى أن يقوم الناس لرب العالمين. Indeed, the message of Allah, it will continue because this is the inheritance of the scholars and this is the portion that been given to the believers. So people can continue with the worship of Allah until the day of judgment. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had informed us, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Ask the people of knowledge if you don't know. This is Surah Al-Anbiya, verse number 7. Thank you for listening. We see you next